Doug, there can be no sound because we're doing a show.
Ezra's like, I want to come in too.
Oh, funny. Oh, funny. Be careful. Don't hit the tripod, please.
Oh. Hopefully the sound is working.
Is he playing with it?
Yes, yeah, sorry.
No.
Get
such a wiggly worm.
Oh my goodness, Ezra. Okay, so before we go any further, my name's Alyssa Price. This is Bad Mom Jokes. Thank you for finding us. I feel like it's probably impossible to find, but you're here, so subscribe, tap the bell.
Tap the bell! 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 Tap the bell!
That's the thing. They're upstaging you all the time.
All the time. Ezra? Especially this one. And he likes it.
He's like,
he's very dramatic.
Nobody wants to hear what you have to say. You could just do
this
all day.
Here you go. Here's the pillow. You're going to love this.
Don't pop off.
Oh, yeah, good point.
I don't think they will. we'll keep an eye on you. We'll pay attention.
Here, you can play with these two.
Yeah, those are good. Those make noises.
Okay.
So I'm here with hilarious and talented Selah Victor.
Yay!
And we have so much to unpack because we met recently and there's a lot of synchronicities.
It's crazy.
It is crazy. But before all that, I'm really nerding out that you're the voice of Chloe.
Yes.
Ladybug, Miraculous.
I am. It's ridiculous.
Before meeting you, we have definitely watched every episode available on Netflix.
I love it.
I have so many questions.
Yes. Yes.
So I'm going to nerd out on you for a minute. Is it French?
It is. We actually dub it over in English.
Okay.
Most of the time. There are some times we get an episode that's not done. Actually, that's been happening more and more lately, I think, because they're trying to turn them out faster and faster.
Got it. And Netflix is like, oh, people are watching this in English.
Exactly. Let's make this happen. Yeah. So we'll get some that aren't finished, either with the dub or the drawing.
So it's still going.
It's still going. And that's more fun because it's a little more creative.
Yeah.
Although the dubbing is also... I think it's actually harder than normal voiceover.
Oh, it's so hard. I mean, I'm not a voiceover artist, but I've had to do it before. Tell us about what dubbing is, because not everybody would know.
Okay. Yeah, basically, you're watching the screen of the cartoon and the drawing, whatever's happening.
Yeah.
And then you're also watching the lines, the English lines underneath. So you have to match the flap, we call it the mouth, of what they're saying with what you're saying. And act, and at the same time, so you're watching the line and the mouth at the same time.
It's one of these, for sure.
Exactly. And I've actually been doing it. I started in college, so many years ago now.
Oh, great.
With some Japanese anime, a few cartoons that I did.
Oh my gosh.
So when I auditioned for this, I was pretty good, and they, like, at doing that, it was just in me, you know?
It takes practice, right? It's muscle memory.
Yeah.
Okay, I have to interrupt this. I didn't give you your coffee. It's like six. Okay,
that's
so every single one of my guests, when they're here, I'm like, would you like tea, coffee, whiskey? And you said coffee.
I was going to say whiskey.
I was running early, which I'm never running early, so I put foil over it. I was like, Are you sure? Okay, so we're just going to... No, we're back. So you didn't... hi. So you were saying you didn't do caffeine?
Well, so during pregnancy, I didn't. So then after, I was like...
You're an angel.
Well... I don't know why. I just was like paranoid. Well, because we did IVF.
Right.
And so everything to me was like paranoid.
Had to be perfect.
Yeah.
And you had to be as healthy as possible. I don't blame you. I have to say, I felt guilty. I drink coffee too.
You can, though. You can drink a cup.
I was like, oh my God, he's going to be short. Because I did all this research online. And I couldn't find anyone saying that it was bad for them, but there was that one thing, and there's a lot of short men in my family, so I was like,
and he's
but
like super
he's totally fine. I think he's gonna take after his dad. So I'm like, phew.
I feel like that.
You feel so
thing,
responsible.
You do, like one little mishap and forget it.
Yeah, I know.
They're like, doomed.
Did you? That first month when you don't know you're pregnant, you're doing drugs and drinking whiskey. You know?
See, and I didn't have that because I knew. And so that I think that was it too. I'm scared of getting pregnant naturally the next one because I'm like, I'm going to be so,
it's
even
fine.
More maybe,
it's
paranoid.
Fine.
I don't know.
I mean, I think they say no drinking, no drugs because there's people that will then do a lot of it.
Exactly.
So I think the doctor has to, by law, be like, just don't do it.
And
it's
everyone
not worth
in
it.
Europe drinks all the time while pregnant.
Yeah.
And I had, we've all had those girlfriends that were like, oops, I'm pregnant, like 3 months into it, and
they
were drinking every day. And then,
and then like our grandmother smoked. And
Seriously. So wild, I mean, Mad Men, they all slept and had babies.
Marvelous Mrs. Maisel.
Yes.
So I saw that you had a reference on your Instagram.
Was it the Marvelous Mrs. Muccio one?
I don't know, but you were saying you had a picture of you doing, maybe it was a picture of you doing
stand-up. Yeah. And I was like, it's the Marvelous, because my married name is Muccio.
Oh, okay.
So my friends were joking, you're the Marvelous Mrs. Muccio.
Oh, that's so cute.
And then like going out late after the kids are in bed and doing open mics, getting better. And that's her, right?
Yeah, and letting it all out, because I definitely, for me, it's more therapy than anything else. At this point.
Totally.
Yeah.
Yeah, and being able to joke. I think actually it's so true. The pain causes comedy. And there are things that, like, pain is an extreme word, but things that you're, I don't know, maybe getting, like, I got, one thing I talk about in my set is I got shamed for posting too many photos of my son on social media.
What?
Oh yeah, someone full on.
A mom you know?
No, it was actually a dad.
That you,
like,
know?
Yeah. And he sent me this article and was like, this is why you should. Yes. And I guess they, like, don't show their faces or whatever on, I know,
that's
on Instagram.
Wild.
It was
crazy.
Was he
a close friend?
He was. And the thing is, I know him very well. And I know his intention was not to shame me, actually. Oops. I just, like, microphone.
But
his intention was, like, to protect.
I got you, girl.
Because, you know, there's, like, there are predators or whatever.
Oh, for sure. Definitely.
So I know his intention was not at all. But I felt immediate shame, of course, you know, because I'm a new mom, and I'm like, oh no, is my son gonna hate me? Am I putting him in danger? And then I was like, screw it, he's gonna love it one day.
Well, and that's the kind of shit you can never get out of your head.
Exactly.
You'll be thinking about that dad and his judgment of your choice to have an Instagram account for your kid when you're 80.
I know.
It's so wild.
I'm, like,
people don't know
yourself.
Their impact.
It's true.
Well, it's also none of his fucking business.
I know.
Because he made a choice, and he has that choice.
Exactly.
And you made a choice, and there's so many different in-betweens. I struggle with this a lot, personally.
Yeah.
With the where to draw the line with privacy. Like, my husband's incredibly private.
Mine too. He's not on any social media.
Interesting.
And he doesn't love that I...
This is wild. We have so much in common.
We do.
This is going to, like, go
like
all
too?
Over the place, but...
He's not on... I know.
No.
We have... We're...
This might just be, like, you're in on our private, like, wait, you, what?
We both went to UC Irvine, which was so weird. Like,
yes. So, okay, I guess we should tell the story.
Mm-hmm.
So we were at an open mic. It was the funny...
Pretty Funny Women.
Pretty Funny Women. That was my first time going.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So you never took her class or anything?
No, my girlfriends... Oh. I have a coven. They told me, hey, do this mic because she's taking a break for 6 weeks.
Yes.
And so I was looking for mics, and so I went to check it out.
It's awesome.
It's a great mic.
Great studio. Yeah. Yeah, I know. I'm bummed she's stopping for a while.
Yeah.
But we met there... Well... So you were up on stage, and I kept going, me too. I was like, echoing her.
It's the middle of the night. There's three people there. But we ended up having a conversation. Yes. Come in.
Edja?
Right when we get going. Hi, Ron.
Hi.
How's it going?
So cute.
Mommy,
can you
send me? Oh, okay. Come on up here and tell me.
I'm really hungry.
Oh, but let me check your number. She a year ago was diagnosed with type 1 diabetes.
Oh, no.
Yeah, and so I have to just check your number, because sometimes when you're really hungry, it means you're high. No, you're perfect. You're a unicorn. Whenever the kids are 100, we call it a unicorn.
You're a unicorn.
Okay, so you're supposed to ask Marcy for something to eat. So what you can do is maybe you could have, like, tell her I'm okay with you having more toast. How about that? Okay? Does that sound good? Look at her. She's so cute. Here I am on Bad Mom Jokes. And from time to time, this adorable little princess ends up on it. And it's like, for moms. This isn't for kids.
Right.
You know?
Right.
And it's like, okay, I'm Cassina doing this. And I try to separate this from my children. But she just wants Molly. Molly the Molly. My third nipple that she tugs on.
Oh, that's funny.
Yeah. What's, you know, the, most people cut a pacifier. I'm going to be cutting this mole off.
That's
hilarious. Wanted to get rid of this mole.
And she
for
loves
so,
it.
And she loves it. Now that she's in love with that it,
that is
get rid
the
of it.
Most hilarious thing I've ever seen
Isn't
in my life.
Wild?
I've never seen
it. Like, we're out in public. People are like, what is your daughter
that is
doing?
So, I think maybe she wanted to breastfeed. I was like, oh, interesting.
Yeah. She did breastfeed until she was about 3 and a half. This one went forever.
That I would have. I wanted to go forever. Yeah. He was like over it after a year.
They know. They know when they're done. My friend wanted to breastfeed forever, and both her daughters, 9 months.
Oh my God.
And she, it was.
Oh, it was so hard for me. I was so, I'm tearing up. I was like so into it. I would have done it till like 3 or 4. I loved it. It's so great. And he was like,
it's so intimate, you know? I mean, not to be gross, but the moms out there know, like, there's nothing
like it.
You're so connected to another human being.
Yes. Right? So. It's so true. I know.
And they feel it, too.
And I think he knew I need to get pregnant again, too. So.
You definitely get pregnant after you stop breastfeeding. What? Okay, can you tell Marcy? Because she can tell her that it's totally fine for you to have a cup of milk. Raleigh, I only have Selah for about 15 more minutes because Ezra needs to go down for a nap. So I'm on more of a time crunch today. So. It's not that we're making jokes, it's that we're moms in between.
We're living a joke, actually.
We're trying to be bad moms, but in reality, we can't say no. Just like sucker moms.
Yeah,
like,
that's right.
The suckers.
We are too good.
Say
moms.
No! Can you, if you want milk, can you not scream for just maybe 5 minutes? No? She's like, I got this. She's like, guys,
like,
I got this.
I know
the tone that she cannot edit out.
Oh my gosh, totally.
Go get me milk.
Okay, so I'll just do the fucking milk.
You're 3? All right, we have a surprise guest, Miss Roz. Okay, but Molly's right by my microphone. So we're just going to hang out. So Raleigh here, her outfit was inspired by Ladybug today.
It was.
Yes.
I love it. Yeah, I can see that.
We got really excited about you coming. And as you know, we've been streaming the show all day, all morning.
I
and
love
waiting
it.
For
and
you.
And I walked in.
Yes. Yeah.
Ladybug.
So we're sitting here with Chloe. Can you believe it, Raleigh?
Chloe. Sometimes they don't get it, like my little nephews and nieces.
It's hard.
Like, what? Like, yeah. How is she Chloe? That doesn't make sense.
Yeah, she's got blonde hair.
Yeah, exactly.
She's not wearing the right outfit.
I don't think you're Chloe.
Yeah. Well, because for kids, it's real.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah. I know.
And I'm so one of those trippy moms. I really love watching kids stuff.
I do too.
I really am so into all of the cartoons and the anime and all of it. And you said you did anime before.
Yeah, I did. In college, I did two Japanese anime shows.
Very cool.
Maybe more. Actually, I probably did more than that. I don't know. I lost track. But because there were so many episodes that they shoot.
Yeah.
And then I came here and I did a couple. There was like this show, you might have seen it with the kids, Jungle Bunch. There was a movie too with John Lithgow.
Yeah. Oh, my neighbor. Love him. He is. Yes, I used to take ballet with him.
What? That is so random. Where?
Yeah, we did in Culver City. I don't know if it's still there. The neighborhood.
I wonder why he was taking ballet.
Oh, because he's a dancer. He dances.
John Lithgow?
I saw him on Broadway in Sweet Smell of Success.
Oh,
he was great. Nice.
He's amazing.
He is amazing. But yeah, no, he goes to ballet. It was a Russian ballet. I'm very
love
legit.
That.
We dance.
Oh,
There's so much.
There's
anyway,
so much.
So many things.
That is amazing.
Yeah, isn't that wild?
I make him Christmas cookies every year, and he always writes a handwritten card and says thank you. He's so sweet.
Yeah, I don't know him. I just loved that I would be next to him at the bar.
Random, yeah.
Yes, because I'm a fan of his. I think he's great.
He's so great. Yeah.
Do people find you? Because I feel like now there's these like super fans that find you.
Oh, yeah. It's
and
crazy.
Track you and you were in this and then
on Instagram mostly.
Yes.
And it's awesome. You feel really, especially like when you feel like you're a failure and like, you're like so much of the other parts
you're
of
like,
your life.
Mark in Minnesota
thinks I'm awesome. Yeah.
He really values
my
contribution.
Yeah. And they do. What's crazy is that like a lot of the Miraculous fans are a little bit older, so they'll write. They actually like are so sweet and so kind and just like really appreciate the hard work you do. And
how
your voice
they're
and,
older because
I don't know. A lot of adults
love
this.
Well, I have to tell you, the music's great.
The music is
the
great.
The theme song is really good. And
it's
I think
really
adults notice those elements. Like they're watching cartoons with their kids, and then some of the stuff rises to the top, and you're like, all right, we can watch
the
this
artwork
one.
Is beautiful.
It is gorgeous.
It's true.
I agree.
Yeah. Yeah. So maybe that's why. I don't know. We have a lot. I just did this anime expo in downtown, and there were tons of adults and older teenagers that were like
we're into huge fans.
Oh,
that's
so cool. So that was really cool.
Go adults.
I know.
That makes me happy because I thought I was the only one. Like, I hang out at comic book stores.
Yeah. Oh, my gosh. The comic book thing. Because it was a comic book first. So that's why, too, I think that it's big. I don't know. I'm just hoping that I get to go to Comic-Con.
Like, yes. Please. And that's, now, is that still in San Diego? Is that
Yeah, it's like next week.
And when do you find out?
I don't know. I heard a rumor they
Send Chloe to Comic-Con.
Everyone wants Chloe. Hello.
Well, and also because we were talking about... Everybody loves the bad guy.
I know.
You can't just send the good guy.
Exactly.
Now, what about the dad who's the evil? I'm forgetting his name.
Hawkmoth.
Hawkmoth.
Yes.
Does he go to Comic-Con?
He goes, and he's awesome.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, he's a really cool guy. And he's big. Like, he's done a ton of voiceover, so I feel like he's bigger than me, so he gets to go.
Got it. There's certain, like...
Probably. Yeah,
it would be insulting if they didn't invite him.
Yes, yeah.
Yeah.
Ladybug gets to go for sure.
Yes, it's her show.
What about the black cat?
Yeah, Cat Noir.
Cat Noir gets to go. So, Raleigh, do you think Chloe should be at Comic Con? Yes.
What about the one with the bubbles?
Oh,
the bubbles.
Every
week there's a new bad guy.
Yeah, exactly.
So is that one
Whoever
of the bubble ones?
Traumatized.
Okay, well, you don't need to memorize all of those. You know why? Well, because you're a regular.
I mean,
if you're on a TV show and you're a series regular, you're not going to know all your co-stars.
All the guest
stars.
Sorry, it's not going to.
You're also a producer. And you have a film that you just, that you're in the process right now. You're
of getting out. Yeah, we're in pre-production. Yeah. We just cast. Three of the roles.
Yeah, and tell me the name again. I'm so sorry.
The movie is called Baby Moon. So
Baby
it's very
Moon.
Mom friendly.
I love
it's really
it.
Funny comedy, kind of like Bridesmaids meets Hangover.
Mm-hmm. Let me guess. Film. It's a baby moon that goes awry.
Exactly. Yes. Yeah, it's like the baby moon from hell.
Got it.
H-E-double.
No, it's fine. Okay. Her mom does bad mom jokes.
Oh,
what
great.
Are we gonna do?
Exactly.
What are we gonna do? And
she's
you know what I found out? They're gonna learn them anyway.
They're gonna learn them anyway.
Yeah. Yes.
To meet the bubble.
That backfire.
She's still on that.
No, she really is obsessed with Chloe. I swear.
She like, what about this bubble one again?
Yeah. Next week we'll have Bubble, bubble guy, the bubble boy.
I want to meet the bubble guy.
I'll find out. Is he in LA?
Can get everybody from Miraculous here. Yeah. So I want
is everyone
the
in
guy.
LA or no? Oh, nice. Very cool.
So we probably could get you the bubble guy.
Okay, let's get him. Let's get the
we'll
bubble.
Get him on
He's
the
like,
show.
And why am I here? It's like, I'm not a dad. I'm not even a woman.
I'm like 20.
I'm like, I'm here to scare you into never having children.
Yeah.
I'm realizing.
Yeah.
We need to brush your teeth. It's summer. You guys, we're in full throttle summer.
I mean, yes. I was thinking about that the other day. I was like, oh, yeah, this, like, in the future, there's the summer break is not fun anymore because it's like the kids are home from school.
Full-time kids.
Full-time,
well, part of it is really fun. Like, I thought we were in Santa Barbara for the 4th of July, and this mom had a trucker hat, and it said, stay at beach, mom.
Oh, that's hilarious.
And so there is that. Like, you get to just go to the beach.
I love that.
There are certain perks and hang out or do, like, I've been doing lazy mom days where I'm like, just watch your iPad, you know?
Yes.
Like, I just, let's all
so
take a break.
Fun.
So
that's true.
No, there's a lot of guilt involved.
Yeah.
At the end of the day, I feel a little bit of remorse, but you
but
know,
they
I got
love
something
it.
Done. Yeah.
I remember when I was a kid, I loved summer watching cartoons all day.
That's true. Well, see, we watch cartoons and play video games,
it's
so what,
perfect.
It's kind of the same
it's
thing.
It's the same thing.
It's like, it's Christmas break. I get to play all day and all night. No one can interrupt me.
Oh, I think I heard outside and thought it was her stomach growling.
No, it's Domino. Domino's like, let me out of this
I was like,
room.
She's really hungry.
If you guys are
a child.
No, she has been fed several times, believe me.
She's fine.
So Baby
funny.
Moon. So
Baby
you're,
Moon, yes.
That's so exciting. Congratulations. You said this is your second film.
This is my second film. My first one was All I Wish. It's on iTunes and Netflix and everything. It's with Sharon Stone and Tony Goldwyn, romantic comedy.
Oh, fun. I want to watch it.
You should. It's
because
really
I love
cute.
Her.
She's
I'm a huge fan.
So we shot it in our house because we're tearing it down.
Yeah.
So we were like, let's just destroy it. It doesn't matter. And so every morning we'd wake up and there's Sharon Stone. I mean, obviously I was waking up before her, but my husband would be like getting ready for work and there's Sharon Stone at our kitchen table.
Wow.
It was hilarious.
That's surreal. Yeah,
it was surreal. And she's wonderful.
Yes. Yeah.
She's just so, you just know why she's a movie star. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like, first of all, she's beautiful, but she's so talented.
Yeah.
She's just so talented. And she's just an awesome person. She remembers me, like, which made me feel like a human being. You know what I mean? I don't know. She was super cool.
I agree.
Yeah.
So you live in LA long enough, you meet a lot of different types of celebrities. And exactly. I don't know what this is, but the A-listers, you guys, they got there because they're amazing human beings.
Exactly. And most of them.
Yeah, I mean, but
there's always the odd few.
Because I feel I have this theory that the lower you go on the ring, the more miserable they are to be
100%.
Because they need the validation, but it's really pushing it.
Yeah,
you know?
Totally. And the movie stars, like I could give you so many examples of where. Like I just felt like I was actually friends with them, and I'm like, I'm probably not, but they're so good at making you feel that way.
I mean, imagine how many people feel like a connection to them instantly, and they have to carry that burden.
Totally.
It was Bill Murray. I was reading like a quote, like that when he was first famous, you know, people come up to you and interrupt your dinner, and he's like, it's only a novelty for so long, and then it becomes feeling like harassment, you know?
Oh, interesting.
Because it's just, some people are so famous, they can't go anywhere without a lot of people coming up to them. I mean, you couldn't get, how the kids are interrupting us, it's grown-ups probably doing that
all
every time you're
day,
in public.
Every day.
Yeah.
I mean, I get interrupted all the time with my voice. I'm just kidding.
People are like, hilarious. OMG, Chloe.
It's Chloe. I know. That would be just, hilarious.
It could happen.
I would love it, actually.
It could happen. You don't know.
But I can see that.
30 years from now. It's Chloe. Here she comes. Here's oh, my God.
Oh, no. Let's interrupt her breakfast. I would love it.
Could you make a message for my kid?
Oh, my gosh. I know. It's true. Like, even at that little anime expo, everybody was asking me to do messages, you know. And I loved it because I'm like, I'm not, you know, anyone, whatever. I was like.
Well, and that's what you're there for.
Exactly.
In that context, that's what
I'm
you want.
I'm there for.
You
and
want
I
a busy
loved it. And I was happy to do it. Yeah. And I was thinking afterwards, I was like, this is so great. Like, this is what real celebrities must feel like. And then I was like. Oh, wait, this happens to them all day, every day, like all the time.
And to see, you are there working. So I think that they're okay with it when it's in the context of I've agreed, you've paid, let's do this.
Yes.
But if it's, you're at an argument with your husband at a restaurant or your kids, I mean, it's like, stop filming me.
Totally.
You know? And now everyone does that. They film people. Yeah.
And I have a couple, like, one of my best friends is actually famous. You know, she's like... She's a celebrity with all intents and purposes. But that happens to us like on a hike or something. And she's like dripping in sweat and she's like, please don't film me right now. Like, I don't want this all over the internet. I look terrible.
And now, does she find, because it's interesting. So have you ever seen Jerry Seinfeld's Riding in Cars?
Yes, I love it. Comedians in Cars Getting Coffee is my favorite.
I need to watch all of them.
Me too. I haven't watched
but
all of them.
But the one where it's one of the first ones with Zach Galifianakis.
Yes, that's a great
one. Isn't it a friend? They talk about this, and I have to say, I was never a big Jerry Seinfeld fan.
Okay.
I was like, all right, a lot of people were, I think sometimes when they're so famous, you're like, I don't get it.
No,
And then I watched his show, and I'm getting it now.
Yeah.
He genuinely has such a bright, happy-go-lucky spirit. Like,
totally.
You can't fake that, you know?
He really does.
Yeah.
And I think, exactly, and he makes people feel, like you just said, like they've been your best friend.
Yeah, and it was really interesting because Zach Galifianakis was like, when people try to film it, he gets really mad. He feels really violated. And you know, I think it's valid because that would feel weird for someone to just be recording
just be like
you.
Like this in your face.
And so
all
it's like
time.
A trigger for him. And Jerry's like,
hi.
Because he said it's never going to end up anywhere because he knows that everyone's posting media and only the people that have like a connection to media outlets are really ever going to
post it.
And it's not low quality. They're doing it vertically.
And he's right. Like, embrace it. Really.
It's like a new signature.
Exactly.
Yeah,
like
I thought his attitude was so amazing.
There's a reason. Like,
Yes, but quietly so we
can
hear
my
her voice.
Fan. I was getting a little sweaty.
Chloe is.
Thank you. I needed that.
Is needing some pampering.
But it is a tricky line. And I always feel like very protective of my friend. But then on the other hand, I'm like, Well, these are the people that are making like you where you are.
I am Chloe on Ladybug Miraculous.
Does anyone want my picture?
You're like, I'm going to. Like, yeah. You're going to want to save this.
Yeah.
Photo.
Save this for the future. It will be valuable.
Blackmail me with this hiking photo.
Exactly.
Oh, I love it.
Oh, my God.
Can I ask who your friend is?
Yes, her name is Jen Lilly. She's okay. She was like a huge TV soap star. Yeah.
Oh, so which one?
Days of Our Lives.
Oh, yeah, that's big.
And now she's the Hallmark girl. She's in all those movies.
Got it.
So if you're a Hallmark fan, which a lot of people are, I'm learning.
Interesting. And I am guessing they are the most obnoxious fans.
They really obnoxious. And I
it's
feel
like
bad
she's like,
and actually, like, I kind of exaggerate. She's amazing with her fans. Yeah. Like, she's so nice. But to me, she's like, oh gosh,
I wish they wouldn't have done this. We're like 30 minutes deep. Here's the thing that's so great about this show. The longer I make them, the more I can say and get away with. Because who's really watching?
If you're watching right now and you know Jen Lilly, I'm in trouble. No, but the truth is they actually called her the Taylor Swift of soap.
Oh, wow.
Because she is so good with her fans. And the fans love her because she's so nice.
No, please. You know. Can you do that in the other room? It's beautiful, but
she's like,
I'm going to make music for you. Okay, that's a ding, 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 ding. I'm going to move on, Raleigh. You're right.
Okay.
She gave us the ding. Instead of the light, she gave us that.
I thought it was my mic, but it was my bobby pin.
Oh.
I was like, oh, no. Where's the fan? Where'd it go? Will you go get it for me? It's so funny.
Okay, so stand up.
Yes.
We met through the stand up.
Yes.
The stand up.
The stand up.
How did that come about?
So, okay, actually it's an interesting story. I love that. Thank you. I started stand up in college, actually, in England.
Oh,
I did a class, and from a very famous English comedian who taught the class at England universities are totally. Wait, you studied in England too, right?
No, Spain.
Spain. That's right. Different. I was like, we both studied abroad, but
another connection.
But another weird thing.
Wait, what was it called?
We were both.
It was the study abroad program.
UC study abroad. UC. Yes.
It was through the UC program. Yes. So you probably had people from
Education
UCLA.
Abroad program. Yes. EOP. Yes. I can't believe I remember that.
So we both did it.
Yes. But he was like this famous English comedian, and he would stand in the back of the room when you're doing your set, and he's like, in the middle, like, it didn't, you know, whatever he found wasn't funny. He'd be like, it's not funny. It's just not funny. And, like, to this day, that's in my head. Like, if it's something not funny, I'm like, it's not funny. It's just not funny. Like, I know. So,
Is the voice in your head accurate?
I mean, when it's not funny, I'm like, yep, you're right, Steve Nellen. It's not funny.
That would be intimidating, though. Because you're just
so
starting out.
Yes.
You know, you think he'd maybe read the joke with you before you go perform it and tell you it's not funny, or afterwards sit you down and be like, you need to punch up. Or,
no.
You know,
he got you
really used to hecklers.
Yes. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
He's like, you'll be able to handle hecklers.
We all were like, by the time we got to our class show, we were actually good because of that. Maybe
he whipped you into shape.
He was so hard on us. Yeah. And he wouldn't laugh unless it was truly funny.
Well, and they have a wicked sense of humor over there.
Very,
I love their sense of humor. And it's very quick and sharp.
Yes. And very strict.
Yeah.
Like, if it's not funny, you're not getting away with it. You know, it's like.
Yeah. Like, I don't want to hear your story.
That's right.
This isn't story time.
Yeah. Get off the stage.
I don't know about you, but I think a lot of LA comics, it becomes more of storytelling.
Yeah.
So I keep trying to, like, walk that line because it's clearly the sensibility here.
It's,
you know?
So true. Yeah. And I think that's becoming more and more common in, like, do you know Catherine Ryan?
Yes.
She's amazing at it. But you have to be so good at storytelling. You can't just, like, tell a story. You
no.
gotta, like, figure out.
Well, she keeps this, crazy pace. I mean, she's just, like, on crack. She's like, you know, blah, blah, blah.
What is this? Okay, great. And she also goes in and out of the story, like, to tell other stories. I don't know if you can still hear me on this microphone.
I don't know if that even works. Raleigh's like, we got to spice it up with some vampirina up in here.
Boom. But so,
why did I bring that? I brought that in for your son. Because like, these are all non-choking hazards. Aww. But I'm realizing it's the instrument box.
It's what was I thinking? You'd be but yes, so I took this class and I was not good. Yeah. Like, not to be, I wasn't actually
good. It's hard in the beginning.
It was so hard. And then when I moved to
can
LA.
You take that and show Marcy, please.
Oh, yeah. I took another class.
Yeah.
And I wasn't good. And I just like didn't have a point of view. I was 22 years old. I was like, I'm never doing that again. I was terrible. I got literally, I had the video. I had one laugh the whole set.
Yeah, it's
so I'm like, I'm never doing that again. Then I did Second City. I was always doing comedy though my whole life. Like comedy, sports, improv. Yeah. Oh, live nude people at UC Irvine.
Oh, you did that?
I was in the first team.
Oh, so I probably saw you in that.
I'm
I
sure
loved
you saw
that.
Me. I was the only freshman.
So for those of you that don't know, I don't know if what's going to end up in this video.
Yeah.
We both went to UC Irvine. And you were in an improv comedy group that was really, I mean, like,
very
it was a
popular.
Big deal.
It was a big
and a
deal.
Lot of people would go out to see your shows.
Yeah, live nude people.
Live nude people.
Yeah, with clothes on, very small.
Yeah.
And so that you guys was were awesome. Great. We were, and that was really what started my, I mean, like I said, in high school I did comedy, sports, and other things. But but UC Irvine is really where I was like, oh, I'm good at comedy. Like, I could do this.
Great.
You know?
Yeah.
Then when I moved to LA, I after that stand-up class, I did Second City all 4 years. I don't remember. And then the writing program. And then you pretty much all my TV work has been comedy except for one drama where I played a reporter.
But,
yes.
I can see that.
Yeah. So yeah. I was really... And then I went to see my friend's show. And it was awesome. And she was like, you need to take this class, Pretty Funny Women. This was just recently. This was literally March. And I'm like, no, Sarah, I'm never going to do stand-up. I did it once. I'm not doing it. And she's like, Selah, seriously, just take the class for fun.
Wow.
And I was like, all right, I'll look into it. So I went to the Pretty Funny Women website. I don't know if you've seen her promotional video. It's hilarious.
I don't know that I have. Yeah.
She does this promotional video where she talks about, like, have you only been playing prostitutes? Like, she makes some jokes.
That's funny.
I literally play prostitutes on TV.
Of course.
Like, that's all I play.
No, it's... You guys,
crazy.
It's wild.
And
anyone that thinks that the industry has changed is got another thing coming. It's
exactly.
Oh, like, yeah. Like,
I
on my
boobs,
IMDb,
so I,
it's
that's
like,
all I play.
Like, oh, I don't have boobs, and that's all I played.
What is
I was
up with
a
that?
Prostitute in a video game thing. There's a clip online. You can almost catch some side boob.
Oh, my God.
And plenty of guys have, let me tell you.
Well, Mark Maron grabs my boob.
I was in like some
Maron.
Playboy movie. Actually, my friend, female
that's
casting
funny.
Director, cast me in that. And that's my big credit. I mean, it's not big, but like people in Yugoslavia have me in their database for it. It's a horror film. You know?
That's hilarious.
It's like, my IMDb page could be wiped out and I'd be better off.
My son is going to see this one day. Yeah. I'm going to be like, great.
Yeah.
But
it's
that's,
so confusing.
So I saw that and then she was like, and like, have you lost your confidence? And actually I had like in auditioning. I was like, not confident anymore.
Mm.
And so I'm like, yeah, she's right. So I took the class.
Yeah.
And the first class, she's like, so you're all going to start doing open mics and a few of you are going to get the bug. And I'm like, I'm never doing an open mic and I'm never getting the bug. I'm just here for my confidence. Like I'm like, I don't know what she's talking about. You know? And then like, I got the bug.
Yeah.
And I full on do open mics all the time. It just is so, it's such a great mom outlet.
It is.
Flexible. It's fun. I do have a point of view now.
Yes.
I'm older, you know.
That's what I was going to say is, you know, when your baby turned, well, your baby's almost, how
he's
old?
He's 13 months
13
now.
Months. So you're already out there. So kudos to you because you're out there.
So
I met
hard.
Her out there. You know, you were out doing your thing. Go. I want to like fist bump
fist
you.
Fist bump.
So I, when my son, my first, turned about two, I needed something to get me out.
Yes. Yes.
And so I was deciding between a tarot, how to read tarot cards.
Class,
how to do watercolor paints.
Oh.
Or how to do stand-up. And they were all at the
I'm
Santa
so
Monica.
Glad you chose. Yeah.
Well, and here's what's so funny is that you know what I did to my, I'm really wicked to myself. The stand-up was the scariest of the three.
Totally.
And I was like, girl, you need to confront this.
Exactly. That's kind of what went through my head. It's like, if this is scary, I should do it.
Yes.
Like,
well, and that's the performer in you, knowing intuitively that there's something there that you want.
Yes.
And otherwise, you wouldn't be scared or nervous or whatever.
Or resistant.
Yes, exactly.
Like, yeah.
And then, of course, I did my first open mic at West Side Comedy.
The microphone
the biggest high.
Yes.
Got over all those, that crazy fear of it. And I was just like, boop, boop, boop. It's probably nap time.
I know. I was like, why is he crying?
And it's cracked. It's just like, I'm so addicted.
It's so
but
true.
I don't think, I look at the women who aren't moms and I admire them because it is hard when you're 20 and haven't really gone through anything
I
to
know.
Be funny.
I know. It's so true.
You really need to go through stuff.
Yes.
You know, where mom
comedy
puts you
pain.
Through stuff.
Yeah.
Hello. Hi. we might have to wrap this up. And yes. And I'm sure when you leave, I'll be like, I want to talk to you about
something. But I have to come back.
And you're going to come back. And thank you for being such a sport. Yes. I know this is wild.
No, next time, yeah. I don't know if I'll bring baby.
Well, we'll figure we'll it out. We'll yeah. It. And it's hard. Chair. You know, I've got my babies here, too. Yeah. Yes, mama. Yes. Oh, for comedy. Oh, she does stand up too. Oh, and you have a show.
Oh, we have a show, Laugh Factory, July 23rd, 7:30 p.m.
I might be there.
Yay!
Yeah, that would be so July awesome. 23rd.
Yes.
Next
I
weekend?
I come to your Orange County show.
Oh, stop it. I don't expect.
I actually do want to see that, though. What day is your Orange County show?
It's Thursday.
And this
it's
Thursday?
This Thursday. I'm in a competition, The Funniest Housewives. It's going to be a lot of fun.
That's going to be awesome.
It's like 100, it seats 150 people. I think that there will be a lot of moms, so I think it'll be a blast.
I think it will be a blast.
Yeah, because I've been doing these mom jokes.
Man, I might actually try to make it. My best friend lives down there.
Okay.
So I can see if she'll watch the baby.
Do it. I'll send you the link. Anyways, this is great. Thank you so much, Selah. I really appreciate it. Thank you guys. And ladies for hanging in there. Keep talking the good talk or whatever. Walking the good walk. All right.
Yes, that's a perfect ending with her.